Okay, let me explain a little bit of what we're doing here in practicing. This loose drill is practicing improvisational movement in a fight. The idea we're trying to work on is with hands up, I'm going to do something to draw his other hand in. Once his other hand is in, I want to use it now for a movement of martial arts to somehow hurt him and make him do something that's going to, as that other hand comes up, open a move. One move creates the other move. Always something flowing. If his hand comes up, it's going to get either broken, hit, twisted, joint locked. Something is going to happen out of it. It's nice to do a draw towards the eye because the eyes come in and provide a very nice distraction. In the meantime, he'll be worried about protecting those eyes. And if he worries about protecting those eyes, in the midst of that, he's going to get locked and thrown and hit or barred. The drill, if you want to practice to get this way, as a quick progression, this is years and minutes. But one way to do it might be to have your partner in the dojo, kind of like a slow elevator going up and down. As they're doing that, I need to work on acquiring finger locks. We can work on wrist locks too. You have numerous locks in your style that might work out. I don't want you seize him. My tension will cause him to react, tense up, and fight back. Passively acquire. Passively acquire. Passively. Sometimes it's just the use of the fingertips to cause that arm to go down, to open up maybe a hitting line towards the head or whatnot. So I'm just passively acquiring. Moving. Taking things in ranges of motion. And also, I don't want to complete each lock, because if I complete every lock as I'm doing this, it's going to hurt my partner. He's not going to sit there and take me reaping on him over and over. He's going to say, hey, no, that hurts. So we need to passively lock, passively lock, passively lock. Practice that, like 3-4 minutes with your partner, then switch. Phase two now. For second level of development, as I'm doing these acquisitions, I'm going to reach out. I'm going to block it. I'm going to reach out and just touch his head. His hands are still going up and down. I must keep my guard always up, no matter what is happening here. I'm going to reach out, touch towards his forehead. I'm just building the habit right now of going in off of these movements. Whatever happens, I'm coming forward through him. Now, there's a lot of avoiding head-on collisions that might cause me to off angle when I'm doing this later on. That's more advanced drills as we get into it. Just in the beginning, building this, I'm just working on acquiring and working on what is there in a very soft manner. Phase three now, he's going to react back a little bit more. So if I come in off that handwork, he's going to draw. Now I think, what does that give me? As that comes up, this is here. This is here. What is where as these movements come in and build? So from this, we're starting to build up towards the hitting line and the locking lines. And it's a fight that no matter what he does, we're going to hit him. We're going to hurt him. We're going to break him down without really having to try too hard to get there. We want him to come to us. We put our hand up, he comes there for us. Because our hand is going to blind him otherwise. We have all these hitting moves and options. Not every lock is going to be successful. I might go for a lock, it might slip out. Adapt, move. Some of these locks will never work. Some of them is just passive ways to get his arm out of the way so you can hit him. Now, I don't want to hit too fiercely at his face. You see me just tapping, because if I miss, I'm going to hurt him. I don't want to hurt him. So practice comfortable, but in a way that is a good habit of a place you would like to strike. Thank you. So you can see it as a soft style drill, but with potential hard style applications. Don't worry too much about perfection. Think about good root and finding what is there. And when I said perfection, I meant don't worry about going too fast. Go slower, slow it down. So when his hand's up, play with the options. When this arm is here, what do I know that could work from that angle position? There's hundreds of moves. You know many, many, many. Allow yourself to become spontaneous, fluent, and improvisational. So you're just dancing. You're dancing to death here that we're doing. In your style, your movement, the art that is you and your martial arts. Zach, thank you for helping me demonstrate. Thank you, friends of Dojo Rats.